And so we've made it to Dover Air Force Base. This is the museum portion of the base. Over here, we'll go check out some planes. Seems for that part. Go for it. Hangar 1301. This is an old Air Force too. Give a quick little walk around here. So this is cool. This shows the cargo compartments of the different size planes and how big they are. You can see this goes out pretty far. I don't know if I ever noticed this before. If this is new, it kind of looks new. This all the way out here is the C-5. Yeah, how big of a plane that is. It's huge. Front facing view of the Air Force 2. Next plane is a C-141. This one I have to be a little bit further away for. Plane's huge. This plane, I can tell they're definitely working on. Must be a new one because they don't have any sign out for it yet. And I kind of remember this being a big open spot, so they actually changed the planes around a little bit the way it looks. So it'll be neat to come back in a year or whenever they're finally done with it and see how it looks. Should be cool. It's all volunteer based here. And it's all usually like veterans and stuff like that redo these and restore them. So it's always cool to see what they can do and how much better they look when it's done. This is another C-141B. The other one was a regular C-141. This one we can go inside, which we're going to. Guess we're not. It's closed. Yeah, they have it closed. It's okay, I can still come over here. You can actually see out onto the base and all the planes. This is the C-141B. See how big the motors are, engines. And how big the wing is. C-130. show you a sign for it. This is specifically C-130E variant. C-130 yet. Let's see up into the windows. Blades are huge. Hot blades. This is the C9A-C. This one, as you can see, must have been a medical plane. It's a big plane too. All right, next couple I'm just going to group together because they're all smaller planes. Having overheating issues with the phone because it's really hot because we're on asphalt, and after having rain, it's now really, really nice and sunny. So first things first, F-106. This plane next. Which is the F-101. This plane next, which is kind of hard to see. I guess since I'm walking by, there's the other side of the C-130. Anyway, so this one, A-26C. What's this one? This one's not a very tall plane. That's probably only about 8 to 10 feet up to the cockpit there. Over to the next one. Maybe this guy here. The C-119. Nicknamed the flying boxcar. It's that one. Over here to the next one. This is another one. Hearing cars in the background, it's just military officials flying around in their cars. So the next one. I'll go over to this one, and then I'll give my phone a minute to cool down before continuing. And from here, we'll go inside. And I'm not facing the camera that way while they're driving by. I don't want to irritate people. So this is the next one. C-121C. Give the phone a break. There's still quite a few more planes to go. This is the backside of that last plane. And we'll move on to the rest of the planes. Except there's still more back there yet, too. I have a whole line to do this way now. I think I should have enough time for inside yet, I think. This one, as you can see, has got three floors inside. Either that or just is a really tall cargo compartment. C-124. This is a Globemaster, so this was a transport plane, but this is an older, they still do see model Globemasters, but it's C-17, and they're way bigger, and they're also jet instead of prop. Over to this next plane now. I think the best way to do this, because there's like six of them right in a row here. C-123K provider. I'll order this one next. That was one we had seen earlier. This is the C-7A Caribou. Those people up there in the tower, I see. This one is C-54M. As well. C-131. Go on to the next. is a C-133 Douglas Cargo Master. The big boy. This way. So I don't know how much of a difference it's going to make, if any, but I notice it's not getting as hot now. I was running 4K60. I dropped it back to 4K24. So it's less frames per second, but it's less intensive, so hopefully I can get longer records out of this now. And when I can, I'm like right now, I've been stopping in the shade to give the phone a minute to cool off, because it's baking. I think it might be worse than when Kurt and I go out. It's really hot. All right, so let's go over here. There's like four or five more planes yet outside, and then I'll quick do a run through on the inside. The inside won't take as long as what outside did, because the outside is much more spread apart. Everything inside is all close together. A KC-135, which is a tanker, fuel tanker. Walk up to the sign. One. C-97. So I don't remember if I mentioned it or not. But this is primarily for cargo. This is the Air Mobility Command Museum. So it's going to be primarily cargo planes. Yeah, there was a couple jets here, but there's not many. This one's being worked on. This one's been being worked on for a couple years. I noticed they've been making progress on it, though. Every time I come here, they have either something fixed or they're working on something new. Which this is why I like coming here. I come here pretty often. Every time I'm down in the Delaware area, I always come down here. Like I can tell that's been restored. I think that might be like a little fuel tank there. But they've been working on this one for a while. But like I said, Every time I come, they're always working on a different part of this plane. So it's neat getting to see the progress as time goes on. This one is KB50J. Let's head over this way now. I have a helicopter out. They didn't have that out here before. That's cool. I was just here in May and never, that helicopter was not there. After these couple inside this hangar, there's only two planes left outside. And they are the big daddies. The two that's left after these is the KC-10, which is that monster there. And then the C-5, which is back there. And if you military enthusiasts know that the C-5 is the largest plane in the U.S. Air Force and also one of the largest cargo planes in the world. This helicopter was just put here. But I don't even see, there isn't even a sign for it yet. That's interesting. They still have a strap on the propeller. And up there too. That's definitely recent. Okay, next one is C-45. Ooh. Temperature just dropped about 10 degrees. This is a small plane. Here's C-60. Also a smaller plane, but those engines are huge. And we got, this looks almost like a training plane here. I'm gonna have to watch my head on low clearance. C-60. Wonder if you can see inside. No, not really. That would have been neat. Anyway, this is the next one. I said I'm pretty sure this is a trainer, if I remember correctly. Just by the way the colors are, I'm pretty sure that's what this is. Do a big daddy since that one's next. I'll end it off with the KC-10, which is almost as big. I think I'll have enough time to walk around inside quick. Probably won't talk for that part because there'll be people around and I don't want to intrude on what people are talking about or to each other. And this is all volunteer, and a lot of them are retired military. And I don't want to put them on video, you know, them talking about stories. I just want to be respectful. So, No talking for that part. Let me get closer. See, this plane is absolutely massive. Last one, KC-10. So I did have a specific reason for coming here today. Tomorrow is 9/11 here in the United States. There is a memorial here. Before 9/11. There's a couple pieces from each thing. I will not be talking once I get to there. It will be a moment of silence on the vlog. But for now, this is the KC-10. So that's another big one. Over to the 9/11 memorial, and then we'll quick go inside, show you that, and then that'll be it. Okay, here's 9/11 memorial. From here on out, there will be silence. Next, we go in the hangar. There's some stuff in there to see. Check that out. Just go over some of the planes and stuff real quick, maybe. Just to show you everything. Gotta remember to look up when you're here too. Thank you. There's a whole bunch of challenge cries. I think those are so neat. Medals and stuff.
Museum. It was supposed to come to the museum before the base program they took the engines off.